grandparents aging. Mic check, mic check. She's gonna disappear one day.
You're making me think about my Nana's mortality.
Hi. Good times. It's Thursday at 5 o'clock.
It's 5:03.
That means it's time for Tony and Chelsea Live, where we review your photos, cover the latest photo news, and
I feel I'm gonna bring the sass today.
That's what we do. Chelsea's had a tough week, so she's tying one on.
I'm tying one on. And I'm going to be mean. So bring it, because this episode is brought to you by Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, hey, make your next move with Squarespace. If you need to make a website for your wood shop, if you need to make a website for your cupcake business, maybe you make a really cool shirt, you knit a sweater, you want to sell it, Squarespace. Try it out for free. Go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code PORTFOLIO for 10% off. You also get that free trial. What is it, 14 days?
Yeah, I think it's a 14-day. No credit card required. So you can just go there, set everything up. If you have set up an actual photography portfolio, go to stp.io/link during the live show and we'll take a look at your portfolio and give you some feedback in real time. It's so cool. We could talk to people.
We are so cool.
You could talk to us in a couple of ways. Use hashtag TC Live on Twitter or Instagram. If you tweet hashtag TC Live, our producer Justin here in the studio.
Hello.
Can toss it up on the screen. Justin with a dogfish head today.
Yes. Yes.
You good could stuff. Tweet us. You could get us on Instagram. You could use a Ouija board. You could communicate with waves and we'd pick them up on our device outside.
We're all just spirits.
We could use
Chelsea just revealed that.
We could use a seismograph.
Or you could write in the comments during the live show, and our producer, Siobhan, out in Philadelphia, can ask us your comments or questions.
Siobhan has one cat, one dog, one human child, and one desk ant.
Chelsea, what's the status of Siobhan's dependents? Oh, you just answered that. My bad. Somehow you read my mind. You knew exactly what I was going to ask.
I killed the ant.
Oh, my monster.
Well, that is bad luck.
You better hope there's no afterlife.
I'm not a good mom.
This week, our photo theme is abstract photos. So visit stp.io/submit and send us your abstract photos.
These better be so abstract.
Chelsea, what is the definition of abstract? Because sometimes people have a hard time figuring out what the theme is. A picture of my cat, is that abstract?
Sure.
No, it's not.
Stop. You know, before the show, you were trying to tell me how to live my life, and you're doing it again.
A picture of a kid playing soccer?
Sure.
Not abstract. Sunsets, not abstract.
All that could be abstracted.
Abstract.
What if you took composition... the cat and you zoomed so far in its nose that it was just like a little fractal nose, and everyone was like, is that a snowflake? Is that a human finger?
I think if you got close enough and you made the shape and form the composition of the photo, if that was the theme, then maybe you could make a cat abstract. But no, close-up pictures are not inherently abstract. You have to be thinking about using objects, just their shape, as the composition. What about next week's theme, Charles?
I don't know. Colors.
I don't know why you had to ponder that. We did this photo shoot this past week, and we used color gels, so.
We used color gels, and now we're all about colors.
You might have to narrow that one down a little bit, too. Is it just any color photo?
No. Come on, guys. It's got to be predominantly about colors. It could make it interesting. You could use color gels, or it could just be all monochromatic in one color, not black and white, but like maybe all red, something like that. Not spot color. Get that out of your head right now.
Banned for life if you send in spot color. What's this about?
I just wanted to remind people that we have a whole website called northrop.photo, which I didn't even realize was a possible domain until recently. And Siobhan, every week, every Tuesday, she writes a blog about what the subject will be on Thursday. So if you need to learn how to do it, like an abstract, she writes about it. She takes some pictures. She infuses her good humor. She's a lovely person and a great photographer. So you should check that out.
Yay, Siobhan. Dang. Okay, we have some stuff this week.
She killed the aunt, which I can't say I respect it. But she admitted she's a bad aunt mom, so can't take it away.
First up is this.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot what this is called.
Mm-hmm.
The NAR box.
Yes, NAR.
Oh, the NAR box, spelled with a G, as you do in the standard way of spelling NAR box. It is 128 gig.
Hear this guy?
SSD with, I don't know, we don't really have a good close-up camera. 128 gig SSD. Oh, Chelsea's got it. Flip those doors open and show them what's doing.
Flip them doors.
It's got, there's another door there. Chelsea hasn't played with this yet. It's got an SD and micro SD
slot.
Is this
the thing that helps you transfer your photos?
Yeah, so you can stick your SDs in there and back up your stills or video files, and then it's got Wi-Fi, so you can connect your phone to it and preview stuff. And it was a Kickstarter project, and I think this is the first version.
I do care about this. I actually saw the email and said I wanted this.
Yeah,
because
if I could get
my pictures to my phone quickly on a shoot, that'd be really nice.
Yeah, especially when traveling.
It feels substantial.
It hasn't been problem free yet. So
did you try
the review
it
is pending. Yeah, yeah. I just want to warn people, like, I wouldn't rush out and get it. Like, hold out for a review. We're going to work with the company. They have updates coming out. So the other new piece of gear we have is the Tamron 70-200 f/2.8, which I was going to pass on, but we have this big monster comparison of, like, literally every 70-200 f/2.8 equivalent coming out. And I knew people would be upset if it was missing. So we're going to include it in that big comparison. We haven't had a chance to try it out yet. Looks nice, though. Who's Paper Boyo?
This is a person, that's their Instagram. And they take paper cutouts and they put them in their pictures and have some really interesting results. It's really cool. It's very fun. You should go there and check it out. I just wanted to share that. Maybe get your creative juices flowing.
Just plug in an Insta.
I just want to plug that Insta. I saw, a lot of news outlets were covering it because it's so cool. Becca must be psyched. He's like, I'm popular today. My paper cutouts are dope today. Dell, I thought of you when I saw this. They have an 8K monitor for sale and it's $5,000. So I just wanted to head this off and say, we're not getting that. But also, it does look pretty sweet. It's got 33.2 million pixels. That's crazy. 280 ppi and 64 times more color depth than a standard monitor. So,
yeah, so if you had like a D810 at 36 megapixels, you would basically be viewing stuff one-to-one.
Yeah, that's why I don't want it. No person wants their portraits to be seen on this monstrous device.
Well, you just wouldn't have to zoom in to like 2-to-1 like we always do on our screens.
Yeah. It's amazing.
I do want it. I'm definitely going to hold out for those prices to come down a little bit, but I'm excited to see the 8K monitors start to come out. If nothing else, like 4K monitors will start to get a little cheaper. $5,000 is outrageous. But just a few years ago, that's what 4K monitors cost. So if you give it a couple of years, I bet they'll be under $1,000. Before we do chit-chat,
we have so much chit-chat this week.
Oh, yeah, it's been a pretty big week.
It's like I think everybody had a bad week because there was just so much. There's so much what on the internet. Do you know what I mean?
Dang, a lot of abstract photos.
Yeah.
I like when the categories are a little nichey because then
we get less photos, but they're more interesting.
Yeah, and we get to more people get their, like a higher percentage of people get to see their photos up than if we just did like cats or something.
What is with pictures. You and cats?
Chelsea, the internet is for cat pictures. First picture here is from Hughes.
You know what? The internet was for cat pictures like 10 years ago. It's all about dogs now. Siobhan, am I right? Siobhan says, not.
Yes, and I accept that change.
She used to be pro-cat. She still is, but I think she's come over to the dog side. Cats, mediocre.
Yeah, dogs are the way to go. They're, especially for photos, they're more expressive, right? Cats have either angry or asleep. Whereas dogs have like other moods.
You know
like
what my Nana Lucy says? They're standing on things all the time. My grandmother.
You have to do the Nana Lucy voice.
My grandmother heard.
Do the voice.
My grandfather passed away, and then my grandmother's dog passed away right away, and it was really sad. So I said, well, let's get you a pet. And I thought a dog might be high maintenance. So I said, what about a cat? And she goes, oh, a cat. Oh, the cat's on the table. Oh, the cat.
cats on the couch. I don't want no cat.
Like, her gripe with cats is that they're on stuff. That was the funniest thing I've ever heard.
And can I just say, Chelsea's not doing a ridiculous impersonation. She's a full 2 octaves below Nana Lucy's voice.
High. You guys,
and
probably...
she's far more intelligible because Nana Lucy's Puerto Rican
you
and just speaks a little
into
English.
That range. She's like, oh, the cat on the table.
Mm-mm, not Chelsea. You also can go. We take
only the dogs can understand her.
Yeah. Yeah. Dogs can hear her. That's why she likes that.
Gwendis.
Okay. Will Hughes sent us this abstract building picture, and I think it's perfect. I really like it. He looked around in the clutter of a big city and found just an interesting shape and made the picture. It's exactly what I had in mind, so I'm going to give it a pick. Yeah, you know, I'm just zooming that back out. It might even be a good candidate for black and white, right? I don't mind the colors. They're not too distracting, but the theme definitely becomes more clear once you jump into black and white.
Let's jump into it. Gladys.
Jump into black and white.
Now I just want to talk like Nana Lucy all day. You know how I love it. This is a carnival ride by Dan Kaufman.
Yeah, I think it's cool. I don't know that it speaks too abstract to me. It just definitely.
Oh,
like
there was more. See, I think this is an important part of the story, Dan Kaufman. You got these kids here trying to hold their lunch in.
And for me as a photographer, it looks like there was also some camera shake in it. Like maybe you were hand holding it. But maybe that was deliberate. I just like things.
I don't know that
deliberate.
I improved
I'm not
it,
opposed
but
to that.
I just wish I saw the people.
This is actually beautiful, right? It's tough to call it abstract, but it's mm-hmm. almost ambient, like atmospheric. You know, this would be a good mm-hmm. picture if you.
Ambient.
We're going, doing like a nautical theme. It feels like. Because people on boats use
ropes. I like
it. I've learned that from my experience on boats.
Yeah, you know what I learned in my life? Ropes symbolize the shipping industry. And a lot of shipping moguls use ropes and their decorative elements in their homes to show where their wealth came from.
There's a whole rope store in Mystic.
Yeah.
It's just nautical ropes.
Yeah, people love rope. So I think that picture was great. You're laughing because you know exactly where I got that information from.
Charlotte, North Carolina.
It wasn't. It was Charleston.
Oh, Charleston.
And it was South Carolina. How come I'm boozing and you're losing?
Beautiful shot.
This great is where building. A supervillain was born.
Can I David. Just say, you were like half a step to the right. I know nobody else is going to notice this. It's really hard to get it perfectly lined up. It's very, very close, though. You did a very good
but
job.
But I give it a pick. I really like this.
Yeah, I give that one a pick, too. Very nice.
No, me.
Like a guy.
Roger Malcolm. Orange Fusion. Oh, wow.
Yeah, I'm going to give this one a pick, too.
Whoa.
I'm realizing I'm just really into abstract photography. You see so many just pictures of things. It's
You're
nice to...
You're learning about yourself today.
It's nice to see people take it to the next level.
Did you learn something
thinking.
About ropes?
I did.
You're learning a lot.
Great job, Roger.
Finally, we found something to do with all those AOL CDs.
This is not abstract, but it is beautiful.
It's interesting.
I'm going to give it a pick. I love the water on there. It's just a
I
perfect
know.
Shot.
That's not safe.
Oh, I thought you had a hair on the screen on your picture, but it's actually on my screen.
We could duck some more.
Wait, do you want to just wreck their picture for them by?
Sure, we do that. You want to crop it?
They do have hairs in there.
Oh, I see. I thought you were mocking that I always raise the exposure.
Well,
do
I am.
Do that?
No. What? No. It's all about the color.
I hate color.
God. It works in black and white,
it's
too,
an
though.
It's an insult to the canines. What's this? That Dance Dance Revolution game?
I think this is beautiful. I love the contrast between the color and the black and white, and you've lined it up just about perfectly. I'm going to give this one a pick, too. Oh, I don't know. I like the mix of color. It's almost natural black
I'm
and white.
Honestly confused, but I like it.
Taken with the M5.
Oh.
This is a beautiful study,
Chris
too.
Chris Holmes.
People are knocking out of the park today. And the nice
Sorry.
Thing about abstract.
I'm the noisiest person.
What happened? Did you bang the mic?
I was
oh,
like,
yeah.
Oh. You also have that cough button there. Don't forget that.
No, it wasn't intentional. I just need to, move. This is a very good pick. Great.
Nice shot, Chris.
First of all, I should point out when people properly expose something. You did.
Yeah, they nailed it.
Interesting composition. I love the bright highlights. It's really nice. It's simple. It's good. Chris Holmes did it again. Space Spider. Making sure I never sleep again with that name. What do you think, Tony?
I think it's a cool shot. I think, yeah, to me it looks like a firework shot, but I think it's cool.
It's a space spider.
Oh, space spider.
Okay. Oh. This is...
What? Dan H264. I wonder if he's the guy who invented the H264 codec and he just named it after himself.
It's possible.
Justin's chortling on that one. Nobody else.
Justin chortle. We got a Justin chortle.
Very specific joke, kidder, Justin.
I think it's almost abstract, but I can see that it's lights near a parking garage.
So yeah, that it's just a very busy shot. I don't.
But if you took it down.
But to I think like, it's interesting. It's just yeah, just there's so much going on in it.
Even just here, that becomes far more abstract. But I don't know that it's anything for me. Matthew Deering, Frankfurt door. Yeah.
Again, I think it's a nice atmosphere shot, but mm-hmm. It's not an abstract shot. It's most definitely a door and a wooden wall. But it's a nice composition.
But what if it's not?
A little bit off center.
What if it's a lady's face and it's just that abstract? We can't say.
I also think this is a good example of, you know, closing in tight on some details.
They called this elephant shapes.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind just seeing those whites a little bit brightened up. Typical. It's been a long time since I cropped stuff.
Whoa. Pick.
Yeah.
I don't even know what this is.
Yeah. Oh,
shooting stars for real?
Are you? No.
Because they're not square at the end?
I mean, it's.
Wait, let's take
maybe
this
they black
started
and
white.
With a star shot, but it looks so.
Oh.
It looks so geometric.
Oh.
I genuinely want to peek in the shadows just because I want to see what's going on in there.
Let's try to reveal his secrets. More coolness?
Well, you just. You crank it up and there's... Wait, did his watermark just come out of nowhere?
What?
This crank it up and the watermark appears.
Wizard. He knew. He knew me. He saw into my soul.
Oh my God.
He knew I'd do it and he saw into the soul.
I hope people run with this. If you have a picture with a lot of black in it, just hide some secrets in there because you know Chelsea's going to look.
I'm
going to
look for your secret.
Now every dark picture is going to be like a jack in the box. You're going to be a little bit tense when you...
It's going to be a clown in there. You are a wizard, and I'm worried for you.
I'll pick for that.
And I'm going to give you a
nice
pick.
Nice done, Richard.
I'm going to hug my folder.
Oh, that's beautiful.
This is sand, and I don't like sand. No, this is beautiful. I lied. I do like
it. I guess
sand.
I just felt like I wanted to change the proportions a little bit, but I didn't really need it. Got another pick.
Jim Setzer, Memories. I like the patterns.
Yeah, that is really nice.
I'm going to bring up the contrast. I'm going to give it a pick. What is it? Are you nervous about what that is?
Well, I am a little. And I was also wondering if... If the shallow depth of field is helping it or not.
It's helping.
In these situations, I will take it at a range of apertures, including like all the way up at f22 or something. And then you can pick later. But maybe this was just... Maybe that worked the best. Can't really be sure. Olivier. It's not an abstract shot, but it is a cool shot.
Maybe.
And it's a shot I get every single time I'm in one of these domed
maybe
cathedrals.
Maybe it's abstract if you make it spooky.
Or if you crop it, like really square around that circle or something.
Yeah. Tony, you need
at
to
at some
use...
point, it just becomes an eye, right? Don't you think that's a big eye just mm-hmm. staring into
yeah,
your soul at the
abstract.
Top?
Yeah, maybe it's abstract. I see what Olivier sees. This is definitely the Louvre.
Oh, I was thinking it's like the ceiling in Jacob Javits Center.
The file name says Paris, so I'm going to go with the
yeah,
Louvre.
Yeah, that's the Louvre.
I like black and white, and I do want to crop out the stuff that's in the corners. Yeah.
I think there's a... Let's go like...
Yeah, there's something there.
Hold on. Let's go original. Let's crop it so that this part's in the upper third. And then let's center it quite a bit. Quite a bit because I'm at an angle, so I can't be precise.
And can I also say there's this one line here, this line in the middle that's almost vertical. and I wish it were vertical or at a greater angle, like one or the other. What? Well, I don't think you could do it with cropping and rotating. I think you'd have to.
I can't really understand this picture. There's so many lines. But this is.
But maybe even, I think even more angle would have, like going the other way would have helped. You know what I'm saying.
I don't. I'm not even really listening, angles. To be honest. Sorry.
Nice shot, John.
Storm I can't pause. Tell if it's the sky or the sea.
Yeah, good mood on that. I like that. It's definitely not abstract, but I think it's very cool.
It's... No. Oh, whoa. Are you sure?
No, okay. I'm not sure.
I think I liked his better.
Yeah, maybe.
What's with all these fancy glass ceilings?
People have big houses.
People are so rich.
Yeah, I think black and white's the way to go here.
Let's just go. Oh, Bob.
Oh, is this an inside of a jukebox or?
What did Bob do?
They have a smoke machine in the corner.
Bob, is this even legal? Be honest.
I think Bob has drugged us.
Bob? Let's just make a little more mystery. Newmark. Somebody Google that.
You want to go over to Siobhan? See if she's got any questions or comments?
Newmark makes turntables, by the way.
Justin, thanks for pulling that knowledge out.
Yeah.
I had no idea. Yeah.
Justin with a knowledge bomb.
Let's go to Siobhan. That's actually one of my favorite things.
Hey.
Oh, hi.
Hey, Siobhan.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
Andrew Stewart would like to know, for car photography, in place of a polarizing filter, is there a good way to eliminate glare and be able to see through the windows?
Oh, no, yeah. You'd use a polarizing filter for that.
I was trying to think how else you could do it. You could do a comp and light the car from within for a different look. You wanted
you could roll the windows down.
You could roll the windows down. Jeez, you're so smart. All right, let's talk about something else.
Fair enough. This is a typo. Let me try and work around this. I am an ego-wee photographer. That's not a thing. And I am starting to get some business. I was wondering, what is the best way to price? I am a portrait wedding photographer.
How do you price if you're a portrait wedding photographer?
Or if you have a huge ego.
Yeah, I was confused about the first part of it. What do you think?
I think a really valuable thing is to become a part of, there are all sorts of groups for that that talk about pricing for weddings, especially, well, it depends where you are, right? So if you're in New York, and you're around a lot of people, you can go really high end and there will be a big enough market for you to survive if you're one of the best. If you're in a really small town and there's only one other wedding photographer and they charge $1,000 per wedding, it might be tough to charge above that, though I think you should. So you'll have to do kind of your own research on where you live and what people around you are charging. And you can do that by looking up your competition, maybe even befriending them, finding out what they do and what they charge. I don't know where you live. That's a big part of it, I think. Yeah. Unless you're doing destination weddings, then you can just charge whatever people charge there.
You want to look at Jim Setzer's portfolio?
I had another question for Siobhan.
Okay. What's your question for Siobhan?
My question for Siobhan is, what's the question from us?
Okay. I will say our new friend Kaizen Writer, who Kaizen seems to keep getting our attention, said that Tony's H264 joke was hilarious.
Oh, so, good. All right. Nerds in the house.
Guys, stop.
Somebody asked, would you still consider the Nikon D810 to be the best overall camera?
I love that camera. I use it all the time. But I don't know. Maybe not the best overall.
I mean, it's hard to say overall because each camera is good at different things, and it depends on the lens. Like, we'll often pick a lens and then attach the right body to it.
Yeah, sometimes we choose a camera because we choose the lens first. Sometimes we choose the body first and then the lens. I understand we're in a different position because we get a lot of gear for testing and because we want to relay to you what the answer is. But what are you shooting? And what's most important to you about what you're shooting? And then from there, you have to answer the question.
Yeah, go to sdp.io/which camera. I will say, in that price range, I just uploaded the A99 Mark II review. It's not public yet, though. And Sony's A99 Mark II, like, in most ways, is better than the DA10. Especially if you shoot any video. It's just way better. It's also a lot faster. But the DA10 still has some big advantages, like a wider selection of lenses and generally better focusing.
An ISO? I love that ISO.
Yeah.
What is it?
Oh, like the low 64? ISO 64.
I think it's the only camera I can think of that's ISO 64, right?
Yeah, the DA10 does go lower and so thus produces cleaner images in the studio. The DA10 still really holds up.
Really like that camera. Yeah.
And you're pretty much, unless you're talking about video, you're pretty much splitting hairs between it and the 5D Mark IV. Or even the 5DSR and the A99 Mark II. Okay, Jim Setzer's portfolio. I glanced through like 10 different portfolios, and this one really caught my eye because of the like kind of bold design, but also this like screen filling up close portrait. What do you think? Does that catch your eye?
My eye is being caught.
Yeah. Great portrait. Looks like a little bit wide angle, like maybe an 85. I like kind of the character that it brings to a face.
Depending on the face.
Yeah, it's not right for 85. Isn't right for everybody.
My face has too much character. It's like chill out face. It's a lot of faces to go around. All right. Whoa. Where do I see the pictures?
Right
here.
You have three categories to pick from.
Scroll down. Oh. Thanks for giving directions.
Yeah, actually, I like that.
Not like that.
I don't know if that's a standard part of the template.
It's keeping it really simple.
Yeah, and I like the way you mix two vertical pictures.
Whoa, Jim, you're doing things that I like.
This is a great example of how to work with different Squarespace templates. Like, look at the way those two pictures work together.
Whoa.
As far as design goes, this is one of the like best design pictures.
I saw that picture today.
I saw that picture too.
I could teach you how to do that. Slice of life. Oh, that is so nice. This art makes me uncomfortable, but this picture's lovely. Oh, no. Oh, these are great.
Oh, no. What happened?
He's playing his fife. I don't know if that's really a fife, but... Oh, I love this picture. Very casual.
Yeah, I like that picture, too. Great light.
How did he get the popcorn like to stock. Fly?
All these shots are awesome, right?
Yeah.
I want to provide some constructive criticism.
I just keep looking. Wow, this is great. Seen that picture. I've seen this picture, yeah. Is that me? No.
Okay, wait, maybe I can make one suggestion.
What?
Maybe we could, like... It feels weird that the boudoir picture's next to this family and they seem to be facing in this direction, like they're kind of looking at it. Maybe if you like mix, just maybe swap those two pictures or something. I don't know. I just feel weird that family.
Because we're like, look at this like, nice family. There. She broke them up, didn't she?
Good shot, I like shooting this, into the sun.
I like this picture.
Yeah, I like anytime you can make a kissing picture that doesn't feel like, ugh. You did that. Good work.
People always say Americans are Puritans, but I don't know why. Kissing. Ugh.
All right. So you can pick up Jim for $200 to $300, $350. Fantastic work overall.
Look at Jim. He's beautiful. Okay.
Hey, you got your contact. You got linked to your email, all your social media. You nailed it. Perfect.
You nailed it.
Sorry. I am here to provide constructive criticism, but...
Get that
I really had nothing
boudoir for picture away from those innocent children.
Jim says, just trying out these dynamic templates. Not sure if I like them yet. Squarespace lets me focus on content, not code. Thanks for your suggestions. Thanks for sending in your portfolio, Jim. If you want your own awesome Squarespace portfolio, go to squarespace.com/Tony. You'll get a 14-day free trial with no credit card required. Set your portfolio up, make your pictures look awesome. You can even submit it to us during that 14-day time window.
Yeah, if you got 14 days, do that.
If you decide you like it, you can use the coupon code portfolio. That lets them know that you heard about it from us. We don't get any money, but, you know, maybe they'll continue to sponsor the show and keep things going. Thank you, Squarespace, for sponsoring us. Not just
Not only do they sponsor us, they let us do what we want.
Yeah.
And they're pretty chill about it.
Yeah, we've had a couple of sponsors, so we're starting to appreciate how chill Squarespace is.
Shut up.
About my biggest fan video, which was actually a review of a big fan.
That feeling when you thought you were Tony's biggest fan, and then Kyle Wolf cried. Tony's biggest fan is a literal fan. Justin, we blame you for that pun.
I think we should share some of the ones we came up with.
I came up with some really not safe for work ones, and Justin said, okay, this is going too far, Chels. Lee Wong said, I didn't realize this was going to be a self-help video. I expected to be seeing technical mistakes people make. I usually love your stuff. This is my first thumbs down on one of your videos. Thanks for letting us know, Lee.
And we got a lot of negative feedback about that, especially around saying being a loner was
the word
mistake.
Loner really hit a nerve with our audience. I'm worried about you guys. Then Lee said, being a loner is a mistake? That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. There are lots of ways to learn. Just because social learning works for some people doesn't mean that it works for everyone. I have learned tons from your books. Dumb. Lee, you're literally in a community of photographers right now commenting about how you feel about photography. You're literally doing the thing that you're arguing with me about. Lee Long, I don't have time for this. Let's go to the next one.
Turns out we did have time, though.
Yeah, but I did.
Dumb.
Nico said, bad advice, watch videos while you're driving. And Tony said, it's a podcast. It's audio only. You just listen. And then he came back like real friendly. But I can't stop watching your smile. Hashtag no homo. But I looked up his other comments and he's been commenting for 2 years pretty consistently. And he said, thanks again, Chelsea. Learning every day with you and Tony. He had a supportive day. He had a weird day. He feels insecure about his sexual orientation.
Thanks, Nico. Don't drive and watch our videos.
Don't drive
and watch.
We did
talk to one person who had a long commute and said they would just watch the podcast driving.
Yeah, I was like,
I was immediately like, please don't do that.
Don't do that. Family said, Chelsea's a complete noob for not knowing who Cubert is. LOL. I still don't.
They actually have the Cubert. Just that's Cubert in the corner.
I know.
There, the orange fellow.
I know what Cubert is now. I haven't played the game, but I know what Cubert is. And John Mayfield said, Stanley Cubert makes great movies about video games. So I made this little Photoshop because Roderick said, Chelsea's idea of Stanley Kubrick plus Dilbert is pure genius.
Peck.
It is scarier that way. Right?
Now I have to bring you to an arcade that still has Cubert and have you play it and then see you enraged in under 30 seconds.
Why
worst game ever, right?
It's boring, huh?
Did you ever play Cubert, Justin?
Yeah, plenty of times.
What did you feel about it?
It was like back, I had an Atari 2600 and it was like really one of the last games I played. It was, and I had like 50 games.
Yeah, it just made sucked. You give up gaming, right?
Totally sucked. Yeah.
Siobhan, you Cubert? No, Siobhan.
No, what?
Why would she Cubert? We had cooler things to do, like anything. Sleeping. Showering. I don't know.
Somewhere Cubert, a little tears rolling down his cheek right now.
Duncan McNaught really made me so mad because he said our video was called Seven Mistakes Photographers Make. And he said, eighth mistake, watching this video, and you have spot color glasses. Ninth mistake, spot color glasses. Don't even come at me.
Not to mention he shot up his own nose.
Yeah, up your own nose. And you know how mad I was about at this guy? I found his Facebook, and I saw him, and bicycling shorts, and I almost posted it, and then I was like, maybe you're letting your bad day get to you.
Oh, God. Oh, man. Now so many people are chasing down Duncan and contacting him about his bike shorts.
I couldn't do it. I was like, that's going too far. You need to just get back to work. It's like, damn it, Duncan! Don't be rude! Okay, I was looking through terrible comments and I found Mr. Twister. He said, maybe you can use the fan to properly dry off after your showers so you don't constantly look wet. And I was like, this guy's got a ton of crap comments, I can guarantee it. You can just search a person's name and see all the comments they've ever made, so I did that. He said, you used to say ESO, now you say ISO. How long until you say SDP.EO? Hashtag lock her up. You always look like you just got out of the shower and didn't dry off. Then he said, it's pronounced Quebec, not like the Canadian city or whatever it is. Like, just look up your own comments. If it's a constant stream of annoying, change your life. Who does that?
Well, one of them says, thank you so much for publishing this.
Yeah, he said, I know some important Nikon people will see this, and now we can only hope they take it to heart. Still a butthole. Just
that feels a little too harsh. I didn't take offenses like shower comments, or I think he's joking about my pronunciation. That didn't bother me.
He said, you always look like constantly wet.
That confuses me.
That's super weird. That's the weirdest thing. Then I wanted to end it on like a positive note because Jim Bandy's so nice. He was like, thank you. I found myself in so many of your mistakes. So much to work on. I watch your YouTube videos all the time and always come away with something good. It's just like, Jim, you're different.
You know what? That kid is going to be okay. Like, the number one trait you can have as a person.
I think he's a kid. I think he was a kid, like, in 1956.
Yeah.
No, he's just a kid from the 50s. I mean, you don't know. What, are you going to look at his picture and predict the future?
I'm dead. I'm completely dead. Write the paper.
Anyway, if you have that trait where you can...
This kid is going to...
Change yourself,
like, you're
good.
You think a kid in a bow tie is... Oh, no. Oh, no. I like how I get mad when other people make fun of you, but that's literally my favorite thing to do other than eat.
Okay. Let's look at some more pictures. I don't want to re-import just yet because I know it will crush Kyle's soul.
I saw that too.
Kyle Wolf also thought he was your biggest fan. Then you had a literal fan. It's like, you're really sending your fans on a roller coaster, right?
You guys, the Camera Store TV is in the chat, and they said Tony looks drier in person.
No.
That, I don't like that either, because that makes it sound like I do look wet on camera.
Yeah, but also, we don't look drier in person, because we went to Thailand, and our friends were like, you guys are really shiny.
Yeah, we're all hydrated. That's what it is.
Yeah, we make oil. Good luck.
What's up, Chris and Jordan?
Chris and Jordan are from the Camera Store TV. They're pretty nice. You guys should check them out. Yeah. They have a live show on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They do. Yeah, check out the Camera Store TV and just search for it.
Search. Do Googles. What's this?
They're Canadian, but they're like, you know, some of the good
they
ones.
They never say sorry.
No, that's true.
Not even when they actually do something wrong.
This is balls. I like it. I like the like gradient that we have going on from the upper left corner, right?
I don't know what it is.
It's balls. We're working left here. I started at the end.
A Succulent by Lindsay Neal.
I just wish it had more depth of field. I find myself a little distracted by the.
I just think if you up the contrast,
in the foreground being
then
blurry.
You focus on the form. I like it a lot. I'm gonna give it a pick.
Yeah, shoot that at like f/22 though.
F/22?
Yeah, just so we have more depth of field.
Oh, one of these. Wait, did we skip someone? Where am I going? Why is this going to random pictures? Oh, there we go. What's this about?
He's got that, like, power where he can start fires with his hand.
That concerns me. I like when people do this. iPhone on couch. I like it.
Cool. Not abstract, but cool. A road? Not abstract, but cool.
It kind of is. Which road?
Yeah, I feel like there's an abstract shot in there. I still think it's a good shot.
Aardvark? Is that really your name? Is that really your name?
I think they were hoping we would sort things alphabetically, which we Aardvark didn't.
We're Cobblepot.
Aardvark Cobblepot.
Aardvark Cobblepot. I really doubt that's your name. Whoa, you just started cropping without even consulting with me? I thought we were married.
Well, I guess...
Do you ever get tired of people asking if we're brother and sister?
Yeah, that feels real weird to me. It's not as bad as when people ask if you're my kid.
That doesn't really feel good to me either.
I'm giving this one a pick. It's an odd shape, but I really like the off-center pattern here. Oh. Though you know I want these to be centered, though.
Oh, gosh. Triggered. Can't have your safe spaces, Lib.
I'm jumping through to find some that are more abstract.
This is just cool. There's got to be a more efficient way to make a road, though. Oh, no. I got to the noisy part of the glass. How did this person do all this? Wow. Pick for sure.
Yeah, that's a cool
idea what this is.
Yeah, I don't know. Is it like an eye or something? What?
I think it's oil and water.
Yeah, I think it's oil and water.
Oh, it's just that looks so vascular.
Yeah.
It does look like it's under a microscope.
Porsche. Oh, right.
Tony's from Texas. He just knows about trucks. It's really rough in this household.
Oh,
wow.
That's gorgeous.
Wait, why'd you skip by all those without talking?
Well, because we're running out of time and I'm looking for pictures that more precisely fit the abstract
theme. I'm going to give this picture a 9.
I gave it a pick.
Because I like Kevin.
And you labeled it blue.
Fitting. This is a feather by Flynn.
I'm good with Flynn's picture.
Flynn Flynn, one of my favorite photographers.
Yeah, I like the shot a lot. I mean, it's all about texture, but the... The texture shows specifically because of the way it's lit. If it were like soft front lighting, you wouldn't see that texture at all. So nice work lighting it properly.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's...
Wow.
That is really cool. I'm going to give that one a pick, too. I mean, it's mostly a picture of somebody's art. Like, somebody else deserves much of the credit here, but it's still beautiful.
Yeah, but they did it. Pick. Oh, keyboard's back. Fire keys.
Very cool shot. I like that.
I like it, too. I think I like it in black and white because colors make me nervous.
What? Yeah, it's about the color.
Wow, you can really do that. I like the
nice shadow smoke. I love the shapes that you got.
Oh, some salty mud. How exciting. By Owen Belanger.
The first time I brought Chelsea to Texas, she was really taken aback by the cracks in the ground. I don't think you'd ever seen such a thing before.
It was so dry. I felt worried for the people of Texas.
Yeah, that's just the way most of the earth looks.
You're not getting enough rain? That's how most of the earth looks.
In Texas, specifically. Oh. Troy Halls. Bare melted outlet. What do you think that means? Is that like an electrolyte that melted
screw?
And then it ran through a filter?
I think this is a screw, and I think he put a crazy filter on it.
Yeah.
I think he might be on acid.
No, Troy's not on acid.
You don't know. We can't be sure.
This is a little LED panel.
I like it. It makes me feel lonely. Pick.
You like feeling lonely?
I would kill for lonely right now.
I love this concept. I'm going to give that one a pick, too. I haven't seen this before, but they are kind of making an abstract out of the bouquet, and I love the way the colors overlap and create new colors. Very cool shot.
Did you see that there was a whole article on how to say bokeh? Do you say bokeh? I don't really know why people care that much.
Well, I know you researched how to pronounce it before your last, that 100 millimeter video.
No, I didn't.
Oh. Nonetheless, you got a bunch of people. I thought you nailed it, but you got a bunch of people correcting you. Because no matter how you say it, you get people correcting you.
Because I said,
who cares, people?
I said bokeh once, and people corrected me. So this time I was like, bokeh, I don't know. And then people corrected me, and then I was like, I need to just find a different job.
Yeah, most people don't care. But photography is rife with snobs. And they love nitpicking how you pronounce stuff. Like, that makes a difference.
Everybody just wants to know something. It's like, I taught piano lessons to children, and I used to give them stickers. I just need to do that. And you'd be like, good job. You had an idea. Sticker. You're special. James Beard. This is great. I'm going to give this a pick because green is my favorite.
Yeah.
And I like lines.
This is beautiful. I think if you search YouTube for Abstract Northrop, you'll probably find the right video where we kind of teach you how to do that blog technique. Oh, she covers it in the vlog.
Yep.
Go to northrop.com.
It's not the same technique, but it is similar. This is really nice too. We're really making it through quite a few pictures. Siobhan, do you have any comments? How are you feeling?
Yeah, sure. I'm good.
How do you feel?
You know, half into a glass of wine. Feeling good.
I finished my Fogarita.
I know, everyone said to get you another one because you're on fire tonight.
It's not really that. The truth is, I drink the same every week, but it depends on how stressed I've been because I react to stress by just going completely.
Yeah, I told them this is you like 90% of the time.
I just go real
silly. Nobody believes me.
I know. I know. Usually I'm just worn out. Gotta entertain myself.
Mm-hmm. All right, question.
Questions.
Question about storage space. What files do you keep after a shoot? Do you keep all the raw files, just all the good raw files, or just the JPEG export?
I keep all of the raw files, and then I have so much storage that I'm not great at managing, and that's what Tony's for.
Yeah,
you're not great at managing it either.
No, everybody is always running out of space. I'll rate pictures, and if I rate them like from 1 to 5, if I rate them a 1, that means I will eventually delete them. So if a picture is bad, but I can't bring myself to delete it, I'll give it a 2. So every now and then when I run out of disk space, I'll go through and just delete all my 1-star pictures.
I don't delete pictures. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Life changes. People die.
Yeah.
That sounds like I'm joking and being dark, but you'll think like a blurry picture is really terrible. And it's your dog, and then your dog dies, and you just want any picture. You guys should cry now. Get a tissue.
My God, you're selling a lot of hard drives today.
Thanks.
I dug out Kyle Wolf's picture because I was about to re-import, and I just couldn't do it to poor little Kyle.
Don't call him little. He's an adult now, and we're gonna meet him in the world in May.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Yeah, he does. I don't know if it's going to be in California or here, because the funny thing is we're traveling to California in May, and he's traveling to the East Coast in May. What are the odds?
Gorgeous shot, Kyle, and shot with a drone, a Phantom, or some sort of DJI. I don't remember. They have the weirdest codes, FC300X. I don't remember what that is. But nice shot. Beautiful color on it.
I'd like to see a shark or a drowning person.
Oh, good. Good advice.
He can take it. He's a man now.
Okay. I'm in room for it.
What other questions do you have, Siobhan?
I don't know. Someone just said you went dark.
I did go dark.
I like it. have you guys ever used a tobacco filter?
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, for, I think, like staining prints? But no, I haven't.
Staining prints.
Maybe I'm completely wrong.
I don't know, man. People keep asking about specific things. Like, have you ever used the Black Mist Pro filter?
No.
And if so, can you use 2 filters together?
I don't know.
You should try it. Sounds like you're going to be the first to know. And that's exciting. What else, Siobhan?
I'm honored that people just assume that whatever random thing they think of, we've used it.
We've used a lot of stuff, but we just...
Not less than 100% of stuff.
We need more stuff.
Yeah.
As a new photographer interested in street and landscape photography. How do you train your eye to see the spectacular in the seemingly mundane all around you?
Wow, that's a really kind of deep question. I think it takes a little bit of practice, but I've known really great photographers that also have a hard time changing gears and seeing something nice in a seemingly bland moment. So maybe it's something you just have to practice and try to see.
I wish I could cite the book that I read it in. It's a photography book that's quite old, but they gave a trick. Like if you're out and about and something just catches your eye, you kind of feel it. So train yourself to pay attention to that little spark where you're like, oh, and then train yourself to figure out exactly precisely what it is about that scene that you liked.
I actually have a...
It's like a feeling.
I have an anecdote about this.
Okay.
Because it's sometimes not an ideal moment. So we were in Portugal and we were getting all sorts of great pictures and we're driving. We're going like 70 miles per hour. And all of a sudden the sun peeks out from this gray sky and illuminates a hillside of gorgeous yellow wildflowers. And out the car window, I just take a snapshot, not incredibly in focus, not incredibly well composed, but after I cropped it and stuff and fixed it up a little bit, that picture, more people liked that picture than they liked some of the more perfect technical pictures, just because sometimes that rare, beautiful moment, if you're a photographer and something strikes you, even if it's not ideal, you just need to take a picture. Maybe it'll be nothing, but you could get a really nice moment.
Yeah, and that's another trick. Just don't hesitate to take pictures and don't hesitate to use your phone if that's what's most convenient. Just get it and delete it yet later. And
even if it's just for you.
But it's something that takes decades.
Do you guys ever have people, non-photographers, tell you pictures to take? Does that ever happen to you? People be like, there's this bridge. There's a bridge with a bird.
You need to go there.
This bird is like, oh my God, this bird is like adorable. You're going to go there. Bring a big camera. Okay? Tell them I sent you. I'm like, I usually go. I'm not going to lie. Usually just take the advice. Siobhan, what other questions do you have?
I'm just going to give a pic to James Griffith's picture. Sure. It doesn't need anything.
James is great.
Great shot, Grinch.
Well, this guy Frankie Adams said he paid $2 to get a shout out, so he wants one. There you go, Frank.
Money questions. I forgot about those.
What was his name?
Pay money to say things.
Frankie Adams. Frankie. We got a couple.
What did Frankie Adams say? Just shout out?
Just that he wanted a shout out.
Oh, man.
Shout out to Frankie, baller with the $2.
$2 baller. What?
Kevin Liu paid to ask, what would be your best travel camera?
I like the Fuji X-T2.
I was going to say the X-T2, but you know what?
We always fight over it.
I get a little more serious and I bring the D810 too.
Well, yeah, that's
the thing. I prefer the D810 actually. I mean, it's a clunky, yeah, but I'm always happier with the pictures.
Yeah, as a photographer, I always have this anxiety. Like if I don't bring my biggest and best camera, like what if the big portfolio moment just happens? What if you just stumble into that gorgeous moment and you...
It's not gonna
happen to me. Fuji has excellent image quality. It's just like you can get slightly better and... I think people probably know that feeling.
Whatever. What else, Siobhan? Oh my gosh, I can't believe I almost forgot about money comments.
Well, somebody just said that Tony looks like a male yoga instructor that only takes small classes into the mountains.
Ew. Why would you say that? I hate it. What are you doing that? Stop it.
I'm just looking at myself in the monitor.
You don't. You look like a doctor
who just got out of the shower.
Tony's way too clean cut to be a yoga instructor.
You look like a doctor that only prescribes boner pills. He doesn't. I'm kidding.
Yeah, you need your weed card? Come on over. I can hook you
look
up.
Like a shady.
You got something wrong with you? We'll
you look like a shady doctor, and you have slippers on.
I took my slippers off. That is not true.
Tell me more. These people are weird.
Nice picture, Jim.
I don't know. It hurts. That's a serious burn, Chels.
What do you think of this shot, Chels? You deserve that.
Purple.
You deserve that suffering.
Let's just bring it all the way black and white. You don't have to throw this. There you go. Spot color is bad. Unless you're making Schindler's List. All right, what else, Siobhan?
Should the rule of thirds or golden ratio be utilized in abstract photography? No.
Not necessarily. I mean, those are just kind of like guidelines you start with, you learn them, and then because you know them, you know when to appropriately not use them. So you just got to do what you feel is right.
Do you have any attachment to the golden ratio?
What is that? That's a fake thing.
I never got it. People will take any picture and then overlay that golden ratio, like grid and spiral, honestly, and be like, the golden ratio. And I'm like, what? Do you just put that over any picture?
Honestly, it's a massive circle you could put over any picture and probably line crap up to it.
Yeah, and who can ever, like, think the golden ratio and, like, see it in a scene and be like, oh, I'm going to use the golden ratio here. Like, nonsense. It's one of those composition snob things where they just decide they're going to randomly
overlay
it.
It sounds really nice because golden's in it. And that's probably the best part about it. What else, Siobhan?
Beautiful picture, John Atkinson. I'm giving you a pic.
John.
Love that long exposure. Not really abstract, but nice picture, other John.
I'm going to say first, we have videos on this, and then I will ask the question.
Okay.
What are the best ideas to keep in mind while shooting and editing wildlife? Get the eye.
Yeah, get the eye in focus. And then when you're editing, people want to see the action up close and personal, especially with wildlife, because you don't often get close to wildlife. So if you have an eagle picture, nobody wants to see it take up 1/16th of the frame. Get up close, sharp eye, action. A unique behavior is especially compelling. So if they're feeding their young or if they're having a knife fight, that I've never seen that before. I would pay to see that. The more unique the behavior, the better. Close up, sharp eye, fill the frame. And then you're nailing it. You loved all that, didn't you?
I just wish you would not endorse knife fighting.
I think that would be great.
No, Chelsea does not attend paid eagle knife fights.
You say they were paid. Any other questions, Siobhan? Wow.
I like this picture, Josh. It's not abstract, but I like it.
Someone on Twitter asked if we've ever photoshopped Tony with black hair. And if not, can you? So we can all see it.
I'll do that.
Yeah.
He used to have dark hair. I think he looks better with light hair.
I did used to have dark hair. I was not born like this.
Remember our daughter thought you were born like that?
Yeah.
She said, I bet Tony was a cute baby with all that white hair when she was little. It was so cute.
This is my third stage. I was bald and then blonde, and then I had brown hair.
And then you had gray hair.
Yeah, and then I'll go solid white, and then I'll probably be bald.
I don't mind if you
run now.
Go bald. I could draw stuff.
Thanks.
Up there. It's just additional writing space.
I like these bouquet balloons. I'm going to give you a pic. It's cool.
I used to shine my dad's head.
Great mood on
my
that.
Dad's a bald man. It really made him mad. He'd be like, like you're buffing it.
Great shot, Kathy. Ooh, that's
why
beautiful.
He doesn't want to be around me.
Oh, this is not
like
abstract,
this.
But it's
that's cool.
A delight. Nice shot. I like that too. Just
I'm gonna brighten
it
up because there's no reason not to. I like it. Pick it.
Oh,
I broke the computer. Oh God. This is so grungy. This is like okay. I like it. I wish there were a little more land. Oh, is that a little guy? No.
That's a beautiful shot. I don't know what's going on with the sky, but that's fantastic.
It looks like a tie-dye shirt. Look at that. It's really amazing. Oh, it's 6:02.
Don't you wish we were hanging out with Chris and Jordan? They're a good time, right? I know they're there, but we can't really, like...
They're probably gone by now once I heard all the bad jokes. If I had to guess.
What is this, like a space station?
This looks very futuristic.
That's cool, whatever it is.
It's in China.
Yeah,
it's an oil rig.
Oh, taken with the
I used my reading
DJI.
Skills.
Ah.
I used all my reading skills. I just made the colors crazy because that's how I roll. Siobhan, do you have any other questions for us? This is great. I'm moving this a pick. Yeah, I'm moving this 5 stars. I'm going to give that one a pick as well. Really good pictures today, guys.
Oh, gorgeous. I love the oil one. I love this one too. Pick.
Make me hungry.
I got to experiment with the oil and water. I really like that.
Somebody asked, as an autistic person, I've never understood why wide angle is bad for portraits. I seem to prefer the exaggerated features and don't understand why it's unflattering.
Wow, I never considered that being on the spectrum could also impact how you see pictures. So usually people want to have more prominent eyes. People find eyes more attracting, especially big eyes, because that depicts innocence and youth, like the proportions of a baby. And a big nose is not as attractive, which wide angle does, or a big forehead. So I guess that people prefer not to shoot wide angle and exaggerate the features because it's unflattering in when you're talking about conventional beauty. But it does look cool if you're trying to really exaggerate someone's character, make their nose look bigger or their chin look bigger, depending on what's tilting closer to your lens. Yeah, you're really bringing up some interesting stuff here. I never thought about that.
Yeah, the average human is very tuned into the proportions of a face.
Yeah.
And wide angle distorts that enough that it feels weird to people. So it's just this kind of innate thing.
But it's not necessarily bad. Unflattering conventionally, I'd say.
Yeah. Great picture. I like this one a lot. Perfect example of abstract.
I like stairs. I love the
stripes. Yeah. And I you know, they work this diagonal line of the shadow and the diagonal lines here. Mm-hmm. Nicely done. Very smart.
Whoa. I like this ceiling with the light. I didn't really know what it was at first. Really interesting stuff. Stairs. People. This is Nordstrom. Good on you, Nordstrom. Really traditional architecture here.
Yeah, I think it had to be a lot tighter to actually call this abstract, but it's a cool shot anyway.
I'm gonna go cool with it, like you're in a sci-fi movie. Let's crop out Nordstrom. That takes me out of it. Not a good crop, but I'm just cruising. Look at these tiles.
Yeah, I actually find this kind of fascinating.
Me too.
Again, I don't find it abstract, but I like it.
I like it.
Give it a pick.
Any other questions, Siobhan? That last one really got me thinking.
Sure. Will you guys do another big lens shootout? There are a lot of new big lenses out there, but I can't decide.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
We do have the 7200 shootout, mm-hmm. which we just need to publish at some point. And we have forever been talking about a big Nikon wildlife lens shootout, which is an ordeal. Like, it's going to cost us thousands in just rental fees to get the gear, because those lenses cost, you know, $10,000, $12,000 each. It's a big deal. But maybe we should do it this summer when we actually have some birds around and stuff.
Yeah, we'll do that. I like this picture a lot. I'm able to pick. Anything else, Siobhan? Nikola Tesla. Is that really you, Nikola Tesla?
Someone asked what Tony's final form is.
Well, we decided it would be bald. And then, I don't know, like, are you just a robot? Are you like Johnny Five? I think you're a cheery definitely. Robot like Johnny Five. What do you think my final
cheery
form would
robot.
Be?
Is drunk robot an option?
No. I think I'd be like in Her, that robot that's just like in too many relationships, but also lives forever.
Yeah, you just have cyber sex with hundreds of thousands of people, and then you just peace out of the universe, cut us all off.
She ruins everybody's picnic by reminding them of their immortality, and then she's like, bam, bitch.
That's my final you're on your own now. Stuck with each other.
Johnny Five is cool too, though. What else, Siobhan? Just give me a reason.
Well, someone just paid $5 to ask if a switch to Sony is a good idea. They use a Canon T3i and are interested in upgrading.
Totally depends what you shoot.
Mm-hmm.
I still wouldn't recommend it for sports or wildlife.
But I like Sony just as an all-around camera.
Yeah, and I think they are definitely tracking well.
Yeah.
Like, Canon just doesn't seem to be making a lot of progress in their development, where Sony is definitely kind of jumping by leaps and bounds.
Wait, how was this abstract? No, I got distracted by the candy. This person knew they'd get me. All right. Well, we are way over. We could stop.
You want to stop?
Yeah, I'm going to give this person a pick, though. That makes a fan.
I'll go to the grid view and we can see if
okay.
there's anything that really catches our
eye. Let's see if there's anything that catches us.
I'm looking specifically for abstract. Oh, yeah, that's pretty. Give that a pick.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that window in the right in the middle there. That's gorgeous, right? Pick.
That's nice cool. shot. Good colors.
Sasha.
Ooh.
Okay. Yeah, that one's really nice.
Good. With that, next week we'll be doing colors. You can check out Siobhan's blog to find out more about that. Tony, are you there?
Yeah, thanks for stopping by.
Thanks, yeah.
You should check out...
No, we're great.
Our sponsor, who is also Squarespace.
Oh, Siobhan, do you have any more money questions?
No.
Oh.
Cheapskates.
I just like to say money questions. Okay, so Squarespace... Check them out. Go to squarespace.com/Tony and use the coupon code portfolio for a free 14-day trial. If you decide that you want it, you can get 10% off using that coupon code. Make it happen on Squarespace, man.
Can we go to my close-up camera, Justin? Because I'm going to see this. There's this little bit of film here. Does anybody like
what are you
peeling this off?
I remember when I first started working here and you came up to me with some like accessory and you were like, here, you want to peel the film off?
And you were like,
most people don't care that much about peeling film off.
You were like, I'm going to give my 2 weeks because that's weird.
Tony, I do it too. I always peel the labels off my beer bottles.
Oh, yeah. And isn't it exciting when you get some new product and it has this like saran wrap stuff on it that you can just peel off?
I've never bought a piece of camera equipment.
Justin likes leaving it on.
Yeah, my Xbox and stuff still has all that crap.
Oh my god! We need to give you that serial killer test if that exists.
You're a monster.
Yeah, you like leaving the caps on your beer.
You're weird. What else do you do that we don't know about?
That's all.
That's all. He still has the car on it, the sticker on his car.
You says, not make your straw wrapper into a little snake that you put water on and then it expands on the table?
I actually do that. That's very cool.
Yeah,
I
didn't know about that, but I'm definitely going to be busy tonight with that.
Yeah, okay,
thanks
guys.
For joining us. Next Thursday at 5 o'clock, we're doing colors.
It's going to be so much fun. Just tell everybody you know. It's going to be so much fun. I can't even say anything else about it. Tony is going to be a robot by then.
Oh, okay, bye guys. See you next week.
Bye.
Thanks, Squarespace.
That is all.
Justin.